Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Seems like you like that piece. It's one of my favorites as well. It's a piece by Romanus Weichlein, somewhat lesser known composer from Austria. So this is our little stop in the smaller town of Innsbruck in Austria. And this is a somewhat earlier piece. It belongs more in the 17th century style. In fact, the name for the kind of musical style that you hear in the beginning and at the end of the piece is known as Stilus Fantasticus, which means the fantastical style. So it's a kind of, almost kind of, what's the word I look for? Ecstatic kind of instrumental writing whereby the violins or sometimes recorders and other treble instruments, they go on really fantastical flights of fancy, over which there is a bass note, a pedal in a bass, which just like sustains through the thing. And composers in the German-speaking lands in the middle of the 17th century, such as Weichlein and Bieber and Schmelter, they wrote a lot in this style. And so, yeah, the opening and closing kind of sections were in the fantastica style. And then the middle, the bulk of the piece, you hear it's a dance form known as the passacaglia, which is basically based on a bass line that repeats itself over and over again, above which the treble instruments have variations. Now, this was a kind of dance form that was going to take root a lot in France. Okay, which, as you can see, we have now arrived in France, in the courts of Louis XIV, where his main composer was Jean-Baptiste Lully. He was a figure that really set the musical traditions of the time, you know, the kind of like dance forms, the dance steps, the style of French Baroque. It all started with Lully. And in our last stop here, I'm going to present to you two pieces, actually. The first is a piece by Lully, a small little overture piece, a passacaglia. And then after that, we're going to end off with orchestra suite, really, called Les Elements, which translates into The Elements. And it's written by another composer that worked also in the same court as Lully. His name was Jean-Féry Rebel. But he was like one generation after Lully. So in this juxtaposition, I think, between Lully and Rebel, you can see how Rebel was looking back to the past, like the traditions that he was inheriting from Lully, but he was also looking forward to new ways of expressing the music. And this is in line with the new YST concert calendar theme of looking back and moving forward. This theme actually resonates a lot with us in Baroque history and even today. So I'm going to do a little brief demonstration right now of what are some of the revolutionary aspects of Rebel's music. The first of which we will not give away. The very, very first chord of this piece is very shocking. You would know when it starts, trust me. And then another aspect of this is something that Vivaldi later also took for the Four Seasons, which is that they believe that specific instruments and specific musical motifs could actually represent things. So in the opening movement of this suite, it's called the chaos. And why is it chaotic? It's because all the elements are fighting against each other and, you know, there's no peace, okay? And in the beginning, you will see all these elements being represented, okay? So firstly, we have water, which is represented by our traversals here. It is a scale that flows down and up. Right, and then after that, on the other end, we have our basses, which keep us grounded to earth. And then we have air, that is kind of quite simple, it's just a long trill in the flutes. And lastly, we have fire, which is represented by, you know, none other than the violins. Yeah, so in the beginning of the chaos, you will hear all these elements are stepping on each other's toes. They are coming like, they're overlapping with each other, and you know, it's all very messy, and the harmonies are very dissonant. It'll be something that is very shocking in Lully's time, but Rebel was really experimenting with these methods. In fact, for Les Allemands, he actually called it the new kind of symphony, and he wrote an entire preface that says, you know, in this piece, I'm really experimenting, I'm going all out, so just be warned, right? So yeah, as the piece progresses, however, the chaos starts to find peace and harmony, okay? So over 7 days, and this is a biblical reference here, over 7 days, the elements start to find their own place, and you will start to hear more extended sections that are dedicated to each element, and then towards the end, there is a section called unraveling, whereby all the elements are starting to find their own place, they're starting to align, and finally the music gets more and more tonal, and we find ourselves in a very happy D major resolution. And then the rest of the suite is full of nice little dances that are very much influenced by Lully, but you can see that Rebel has also modernized some of Lully's traditions as well. So, yeah, without further ado, we are going to first perform the Passacaglia by Lully and followed by the Les Allemands by Rebel. But before that, our harpsichordist Gerald Lim is also going to give us a little teaser of how this Lully Passacaglia sounds like on the harpsichord in a transcription written by a fellow French composer, Dong Lebert. Please enjoy.